Welcome to How to Art.
Are you filming?
Yeah.
Welcome to How to Art with us. We're here with Heather Olsen today. She's super cool. And this is where she comes every day to do art. How long have you been doing art?
Technically since I could hold a pencil, I guess. Oh. I was really, really little and just was one of those weird kids that would sit and play and, you know, draw and stuff.
Yeah.
And I actually remember as like a 6-year-old, I took my Barbies and made them into a still life. Like I posed them.
Whoa.
And then I drew
it. Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Wow, so forever she's doing art.
Yeah, so my parents put me in art classes when I was like 8 and then it kind of just took off.
Well, it's definitely paid off.
Professionally, probably 4 years. Since I sold like my first one and, you know, like did it for money. So instead of just for fun.
Sounds to me like you're living the dream.
Some days. It's hit and miss.
What's the best work that you think you've done?
That's a good question. I'm pretty critical of myself, so I'm very, I don't know. Every painting that I do, I'm always like, oh, I could do so much better. And so every painting, I feel like I never quite do. I'm not satisfied.
Oh, really?
If that makes sense.
So does it get better and better, do you feel like?
I feel like I do make progress, but sometimes I get those ones that are just crap. And I'm like, oh, no. And
really?
I usually paint them out. So, but so far, I would say my favorite is probably the self-portrait that I did, because it was so emotional.
Yeah.
It was like a rough time of life, like everybody in my family was dying, and it was a whole thing. So, yeah, it was the most honest painting I've done. So
I think it's really powerful.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Heather's gonna teach us how to draw prints in honor of the late eccentric legend.
You're going to want to box in his head first. So everything can fit in a box. And then you kind of want to get where his eyes are going to be. Well, like lined as to where his eyes are going to be. Maybe just a little indication of where his nose is. Like the jaw a little bit and just go over some of the lines that I think are correct. I like to start with the eyes when I start to lay things in. So I like to get the eyebrow shape in and then just kind of where the eyes are gonna be. Nose, it might be a little like short, so you might want to bring it down a little bit. Shade just a little bit. You don't want to do too much shading on the nose because it'll flatten it out, but you do want to see kind of where his nose is. Eyes might be a little bit small, so you can always come in and make things bigger, but when you have it like vaguely mapped in, it's easier to change than if you have stuff super set in stone. Okay, I'm gonna do this weird little mustache. Just because that'll help to find where the lips are. And you want to always be checking your verticals and horizontals. So like where the corner of his lips come with his eyes and where they are in relation to his nose. Done him a little bit too narrow, his face, so you can always bring it out as needs be. And I'm just gonna do just some shading for it. You wanna do like the darkest darks first, so where you see the most shading, like under the lip, and then you kinda go from there. And then we'll just get the shape of his head. And then he's got some big hair, so we're just gonna like vaguely put in where we think the hair should be. It might be off a little bit, but we can like bring it in or whatever later, but just gives us a sense as to where his face is. And then if you want to do his like smolder, look, he's got some cheekbones. Alright, so I'm just gonna like vaguely put in some lines for his lips, because I don't want to overdo it. He does have some very soft, subtle lips.
Wow.
Is that good? Or do you want me to do more?
Oh, that's great.
Perfect.
Well, everyone, you just got a lesson from a master.
Last week, we made a challenge video and we sent it to Heather that said, well, watch it now.
We have a challenge for you. The challenge is to paint a picture of a squirrel using nothing but sticks and twigs.
But while we were there with Heather just now, we totally forgot to have her show us the thing that she made.
So we have it here on my phone.
We're gonna look at it right now.
Picture and so you're probably already seeing it right now, but we're about to see it for the first time. Whoa! She actually made it out of twigs.
Wow. That's open to interpretation.
Crazy. I wasn't very specific. I thought she was gonna actually use paints with it, but this is way better.
This is crazy.
Whoa.
Wow.